Now using PI853, I can satisfy the need of P0. So P1, P2, P0 is in a safe state. So request 1 can be satisfied. Sorry. Now see here, there is 3 and we require 4. Okay, so it is in unsafe. We cannot satisfy the need of P0. For satisfying the need of P0, we required 4. This is the need, that is 4. But what is available is 3. So we cannot satisfy the need of P0. So system will be in an unsafe state. So this request cannot be granted. Now we will see what happens if P1 will be requesting. So the P0 is not changed. The request of P1 is increased from 3 to 5. And the request of P2 is as it is. Again, the available is 3, 2, 2. So by using 3, 2, 2, I can satisfy the need of P2. So by satisfying the need of P2, it will release its resources. So the new resources become 3 plus 2, 5, 2 plus 1, 3, 2 plus 1, 3. By using 5, 3, 3, I can satisfy the need of P1. So after satisfying the need of P1, it will release its resources. So it becomes 3, 5, 3. Now by using 853, I can satisfy the need of P0. So this will be in a safe state. There will be no deadlock. So only request 2 will be satisfied or served. Request 1 will not be served because it will incur an unsafe state or a deadlock. Another type of question that has been asked in a gate examination based on deadlock is, if there are 3 processes, that is consider there are 3 processes and each need 3 tapes maximum. So this is the maximum need. Then how many number of resources are required so that deadlock will not incur? Now see, this is little bit of tricky question which is not seen in a regular thing. Now what we have to see over here is, we have to first do the allocation and then we have to see what will be the available. If the value of available is 1, it implies there is no deadlock. And if there is a value 0, then it shows that it is a deadlock. This is the value of available. Now what you have to do over here, whatever there is maximum need. Okay, so first allocate maximum minus 1 resources to your all processes. So maximum is 3, so allocate 2 process to each your process. Okay, so we have allocated 2 resources to each process. So there are total 6 resources that has been allocated. Now see, if there is a 0 in available, so it will incur a deadlock. So what we have to find out is how many number of resources are required so deadlock will not happen. If deadlock will not happen, then available should be 1. Now see, the total allocation is 6 plus the available 1, that is also resources. Total 7 resources are required so that there will be a no deadlock. Okay, so total 7 resources will be required so that there will be no deadlock. Another type of question can be asked, how many number of resources will be there so that there will be a deadlock. So for deadlock, the available will be 0. So 6 plus 0, that is 6. So there will be total 6 resources. Okay. Another type of question can be asked, that if there are 6 number of or 7 number of resources, if the number of resources is equals to 7 and the maximum need of a processes is 3. Then how many processes can be served by using the 7 resources so that there will be a no deadlock? So you can allocate 2 resources, and if the available is 1, then there will be no deadlock. So only 3 processes request can be served, not more than 3. Okay, again see what we have done. We are having 3 processes. Each process maximum need is 3. So what we have done, we have allotted maximum minus 1 resources to each process. So total 6 resources has been allocated. Now if the value of available is 1, then there will be a no deadlock. And if the available is 0, then there will be a deadlock. So read the question whether they have asked you the situation when deadlock arises or not arise. As they have asked you that there will be not a deadlock, we have to add available 1 into the allocation and we will get the answer 7. if they asked you the question that when will be deadlock will appear, then we have to add 0 to the allocation and it will give you answer the 6. So question can be asked for how many number of resources or how many number of processes can be solved by using this number, many number of resources. So this is all about deadlocks or what are the different types of question that can be, especially a numerical types of question that can be asked in a GATE examination. Thank you.